Hey everybody, happy be here. On my previous video, I was creating a toy-like railroads with 3D Max, and here I'm going to use this railroad inside my Unity train game. I have this train, the locomotive, and the wagons, and the path or destination points. If I play the game, the train will move according to those destination points. And what I'm going to do in this video is to import that railroad and place it here on the scene. I'm going to delete this destination points, and then I'm going to put this destination point object into another layer that we have here. I will add a new layer. I call it non-visible. Then this destination point, I set its layer to number 6, non-visible. I go to my camera and uncheck this non-visible layer. By doing this, we can see the destination point object here on the scene only, but if we play the game, we won't see that. We won't see it again. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to import the railroad model here. Oh yeah, I will need to create a prefab of this destination point. So I drag and drop it here inside this assets folder. Now I delete this object from the scene. Here is my railroad object. I'm going to use the first one. Okay, let me just drag and drop it to the scene like this. Then I will unpack this prefab, unpack completely, put them out of the parent. This is my first railroad. What I will do is to make a prefab of this railroad object this way. Then I will open the prefab and place my destination point object here. Let me set the position to 0, 0 and 0, x, y and z. If you see the rail object is too small here. But let me move this object here. I don't know is it too small or not, but let's just try it. Duplicate. Somehow I place it here and here. Then what I'm going to do is to place this railroad here, and I can duplicate this prefab somehow this way, and let's see if the train can move across this railroad. Right, you can see it moving that way. It will go back and it is crushing the wagon. Okay, no problem. The next thing that I'm going to do is to do the same thing for the rest of the railroads here. Then I will build a railroad that is in loop, so the train can move in loop. I will pause the video and I will do the railroad prefab building and get back to you. Okay, I have those destination points already placed on every single railroad object here, and now I'm ready to place the rails, the railroad objects, to form some circuit of railroad. So if I duplicate the railroad like this, and then I can place it exactly here, and I like to do it by pressing this V button on keyboard for vertex snap. So now this two railroads is attached perfectly like this. I will do the rest of this process and I will pause the video and I will get back to you. Alright guys, I have the circuit now, the circuit of railroad, and I'm ready to click the play button and see how my train moves across the circuit. Click the play button. Here you can see the train is start moving on the road. The only next thing that you need to do is to place the train on the railroad initially and see how it will move. You can see the train is going outside the railroad. It is because the turning speed of this train is too low. You can increase the turning speed here by clicking this locomotive object and increase the turning speed to any higher number. For example, let me use 2 to make it turn faster. And you can increase the speed of the train by, for example, let me set it to 10. But the wagon is detached. Let's just use 2. When you increase the speed of the locomotive, you will need to increase the speed of the wagon, and make sure you are using same number of the wagon speed. The speed of wagon is 3. You must use 3 as the speed of the locomotive. Next time I will make a simple setting. So whenever I set the speed of the locomotive, the wagon speed must be following the same speed of the locomotive. Okay, that's all for this video, and thank you for watching. As you can see, we need to do more tweaks for the train, so we should not see this strange movement. Okay, that's all for this video. See you next time on my next video. Bye bye.